Where's your granddaughter?
She's at her mum's.
Horrid.
Christ, the light of the world, has come to dispel the darkness of our hearts. In his light, let us examine ourselves and confess our sins. Lord of grace and truth, we confess our unworthiness to stand in your presence as your children. We have sinned. Forgive and heal us. The Virgin Mary accepted your call to be the mother of Jesus. Forgive our disobedience to your will. We have sinned. Forgive and heal us. Your Son, our Saviour, was born in poverty in a manger. Forgive our greed and rejection of your ways. We have sinned. Forgive
and heal us.
The shepherds left their flocks to go to Bethlehem. Forgive our self-interest and lack of vision. we have sinned. Forgive and heal us. The wise men followed the star to find Jesus the King. Forgive our reluctance to seek you. We have sinned. Forgive and heal us. May the God of all healing and forgiveness draw you to himself, that you may behold the glory of his Son, the Word made flesh, and be cleansed from all your sins, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest, and peace to his people on earth. Lord God, heavenly King, almighty God and Father, we worship you, we give you thanks, we praise you for your glory. Lord Jesus Christ, only Son of the Father, Lord God, Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, receive our prayer. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father.
Amen.
Let us pray in the peace of this Christmas celebration that our joy in the birth of Christ will last forever. Eternal God, who made this most holy night to shine with the brightness of your one true light, bring us with the brightness of your one true light, bring us who have known the revelation of that light on earth to see the radiance of your heavenly glory. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
Please be seated for the readings.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. How beautiful upon the mountains are the feet of the messenger who announces peace, who brings good news, who announces salvation, who says to Zion, your God reigns. Listen, your sentinels, lift up their voices. Together they sing for joy, for in plain sight they see the return of the Lord to Zion. Break forth together into singing, your ruins of Jerusalem. For the Lord has comforted his people, he has redeemed Jerusalem. The Lord has bared his holy arm before the eyes of all the nations, and all the ends of the earth shall see the salvation of our God. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The response to the psalm is, all the ends of the earth have seen the victory of our God. All the ends of the earth have seen the victory of our God. Sing to the Lord a new song, for he has done marvelous things. With his right hand and his holy arm has he won for himself the victory. All the ends of the earth have seen the victory of our God. The Lord has made known his victory. His righteousness has he openly shown in the sight of the nations. He remembers his mercy and faithfulness to the house of Israel. And all the ends of the earth have seen the victory of our God. All the ends of the earth have seen the victory of our God. Shout with joy to the Lord, all your lands. Lift up your voice, rejoice and sing. Sing to the Lord with the harp and the voice of song, with trumpets and the sound of the horn. Shout with joy before the King, the Lord. All the ends of the earth have seen the victory of our God. Let the sea make a noise and all that is in it, the lands and those who dwell thereon. Let the rivers clap their hands, and let the hills ring out with joy before the Lord, when he comes to judge the earth. In righteousness shall he judge the world, and the peoples with equity. All the ends of the earth have seen the victory of our God. Second
gospel to our ancestors in many and various ways by the prophets. But in these last days he has spoken to us by his Son, whom he appointed heir of all things, through whom he also created the worlds. He is the reflection of God's glory and the exact imprint of God's very being, and he sustains all things by his powerful word. When he had made purification for sins, he sat down at the right hand of the Majesty on high, having become as much superior to the angels as the name he has inherited in more excellent ways. This is the word of the Lord.
We have seen his glory, the glory This is the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
May the words of my lips and the meditation of all our hearts be acceptable in your sight, O Lord, our strength and our redeemer. Amen. Please be seated. And all the fear the news of his birth instilled in King Herod. while John speaks to us of a light that can never be extinguished, no matter how deep the darkness we encounter. And let's face it, this year we've had more than our fair share of darkness to contend with. So as we begin our somewhat subdued COVID Christmas celebrations this year, many of us separated from our family and friends at a time when coming together is usually so important. We have a lot to think about. We return to these Christmas stories every year, but we can never exhaust what they have to tell us. The very thought of God becoming a human being is enough to contemplate for a lifetime. So this COVID Christmas, let us spend some quiet time, today, tomorrow, pondering the birth of Christ and kneeling in adoration at the manger throne of the Son of God. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen.
So let us now stand and affirm our faith in Jesus Christ, the Son of God. Though he was divine, he did not cling to equality with God, but made himself nothing, taking the form of a slave. He was born in human likeness. He humbled himself and was obedient to death, even death of the cross. Therefore God has raised him on high and given him the name above every name, that at the name of Jesus every knee should bow and every voice proclaim that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father.
Amen.
So let us pray. Please be seated on the Father, in this holy night, your Son, our Saviour, was born in human flesh. Renew your church as the body of Christ. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
In this holy night, there was no room for your Son in the inn. Protect with your love those who have no home and all who live in poverty. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
In this holy night, Mary, in the pain of labour, brought your Son to birth. Hold in your hand all who are in pain or distress. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
In this holy night, your Christ came as a light shining in the darkness. Bring comfort to all who suffer in the sadness of our world. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
In this holy night, the angels sang, peace to God's people on earth. Strengthen those who work for peace and justice in all the world. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
In this holy night, shepherds in the field heard good tidings of joy. Give us grace to preach the gospel of Christ's redemption. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
In this holy night, strangers found the Holy Family and saw the baby lying in the manger. Bless our homes and all whom we love. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
In this holy night, Christians the world over celebrate Christ's birth. open our hearts, that he may be born in us today. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Father, in this holy night, angels and shepherds worshipped at the manger throne. Receive the worship we offer in fellowship with Mary, Joseph, and Joseph John the Baptist, through whom, him who is your word made flesh. Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Stand now for the peace. This holy night, the angels sang glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace to all in whom he delights. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Let us offer one another a socially distant sign of the peace.
Peace be with you. Peace be with you.
Lift our voices to proclaim the glory of your name. comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. We praise and bless you, loving Father, through Jesus Christ our Lord. And as we obey his command, send your Holy Spirit, that broken bread and wine outpoured may be for us the body and blood of your dear Son. On the night before he died, he had supper with his friends, and taking bread, he praised you. He broke the bread, gave it to them, and said, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." When supper was ended, he took the cup of wine. Again he praised you, gave it to them, and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it, in remembrance of me." So, Father, we remember all that Jesus did. In him we plead with confidence his sacrifice made once for all upon the cross. Bringing before you the bread of life and the cup of salvation, we proclaim his death and resurrection until he comes in glory. Christ is the bread of life. When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, Lord Jesus, until you come in glory. Lord of all life, help us to work together for that day when your kingdom comes, and justice and mercy will be seen in all the earth. Look with favour on your people, gather us in your loving arms, and bring us with all the saints to feast at your table in heaven. Through Christ, and with Christ, and in Christ, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honour and glory are yours, O loving Father, for ever and ever.
Amen.
Rejoicing in the presence of God here among us, let us pray with confidence as our Saviour has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever.
Amen.
We break this bread to share in the body of Christ.
Though we are many, we are one body, because we all share in one bread.
Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world.
Have mercy on us.
Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world.
Grant us peace.
Christ is the bread which has come down from heaven. Lord, give us this bread
for me.
I will bring communion to you. Let us pray. God, our Father, in this night you have made known to us again the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. Confirm our faith and fix our eyes on him until the day dawns and Christ, the morning star, rises in our hearts. To him be glory, both now and forever.
Amen.
Would you please stand for the blessing? So may God, the Father, who created all things, assure you of his love and mercy. May our Lord Jesus Christ, the living Word of God, walk alongside you and reveal to you his glory. May the Holy Spirit empower you to live as a child of God, full of grace and truth. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, be among you and remain with you.